This is the story of Appleby Primary School's 1993 Year 4 residential to Eden Valley Centre. These are evacuees. Imagine yourself back in the 1940s. And they have just disembarked from their train from the big city. They are coming to spend their war in the countryside. There's a 2 mile walk, however, to the house in which they're to be evacuated. City kids aren't used to snow like this. Eventually they arrive at what is to be their home for the next week, Eden Valley Centre. And their first job that evening is to act as blackout wardens, searching for stray light.
Lights off, please. Lights off.
The next day, the locals challenge them to feats of bravery and courage. After all, city kids are wimps, aren't they?
The life of the Eden Valley, out in the countryside. We here, at the Eden Valley Centre, need to see just what you're made of. Just what sort of people you are, and how you're going to cope with the challenges of living out here in the wilderness.
So you want to be careful.
One of the feats they are challenged to is searching for unexploded bombs.
The house thing. That is
number
fisherman's hut.
If you find a bomb, you call out.
I'll tell you what to do in a minute, Rebecca.
Where are we?
Good question. Right. Do you see? Number one, the catkin trees.
Yeah.
Well, just down there. I can see a tree with catkins on it.
Yeah.
Can you see them?
In the back.
And do you see where the track curves up?
Yeah.
That's the track curving round towards us. So we're just above the catkin trees at the top corner of the map there. Whichever team comes back with the most bombs, I think they deserve to be
enough. Oh, they're rushing.
Okay, so you're ready for it.
Wish them well.
I want you to write your leaving time down. Your team can go first. Remember and write your names and your bits of paper.
What time is it?
It's 12:11 by my watch.
Okay.
By your watch. Level 7.
Oh,
remember that. Now, you're going to have 20 minutes to go round. So it'll be 27 on your watch.
Okay.
And I want to meet you back at this corner, just up from the fisherman's hut.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
May the force be with you, lads. Off you go.
And if that wasn't hard enough, abseiling down this rock face is the next challenge.
Alright? It's this hand which controls his descent. Up to go, down to stop. He's leaning back almost like he's in bed. Hey, come on. Who's been doing this longer? You or me? Right, well, you got it. Lean back. Lift the bottom hand to go. Don't grip with the top hand, let it slide. That's it. Wide apart. Excellent. Feet wide apart. Now you've got to get your feet wide apart, Dan. That's it. Now keep them where they are. Feet where they are. Lift your foot back up. Lean back. So your body's flat. That's it. Much better. Brilliant. Off you go. Darling, you've got to lean back. You must lean back.
I'm trying.
This is a kamikaze trick. Brilliant. That's good. That's good, get your feet on. Feet on.
Then for some there's rock climbing. The local people know some spots in the Inn Valley that are very difficult to get to.
Now what you're going to do is use one hand on the rope, just one hand, I suggest your left hand, and the other hand on the rock, just walk along, it's edge here towards me. Steady now, don't fall in, it's very deep. Quick, come all of me, quick, come all of me. Well done, in you go.
Oh, no, she didn't.
Have one through there.
Satisfied that we were brave enough, the locals, that evening, let us listen to a news broadcast on the radio. And there we heard what they already knew. That the evening before, a German bomber had crashed in the hills nearby. The gunner and navigator had been found dead in the wreckage, but the pilot had been seen parachuting down in the vicinity of Ainstable. He had not yet been found. And so the locals asked us the next day whether we would help look for the missing pilot. We all had a good breakfast for the adventure ahead. And so we made our way to Broomrigg Wood, where the pilot had been seen coming down, and followed a trail of torn parachute.
Shout out louder.
We're here to help!
Wait there.
We all thought it was the pilot we had seen running away through the forest. But his white hair gave away the fact that he was a war-crazed veteran who roamed the forests.
Oh, you touched it! The data saw a ripple.
The water in the forest streams was polluted and poisonous, and so we had zip wires and rope bridges to help us cross it safely. And then we had our first glimpse of the pilot.
We must feed!
Come in,
please, come on! Come on!
Get this food out!
It's frightened!
It's frightened, come on!
What's going on the way?
Just wait, when you get underneath there, Robert, wait.
But I think we should surround him. Oh, it's attack people at a time.
There's no mines around that side.
Things are moving unless it's weird.
There were still many obstacles, but a note from Hans meant that we were getting nearer. Then we came to an area of poisonous mustard gas.
We might trip on a mine or something. Yeah. Well, let's push him away safe. Back off, everybody. Push him away safe.
Back off.
I don't want to eat it.
Oh, look, it is.
I reckon Greg has found it.
His glass, this goes off.
Bullets!
Are you ready to throw yourselves glass on the floor if it explodes?
There's the lid.
Stay back.
Shield your faces and your eyes if it does.
I'm not shielding my face.
Done it. Hugh, false alarm. Oh, no. What's it say? I don't know.
It's in German. Oh, no.
Are you sure?
Yes.
That evening, we managed to translate the note in German from Hans. It said, "You will find me tomorrow along the Eden Valley between Lazenby and Armathwaite." And so the next day, we set out in two parties, one from Lazenby and one from Armathwaite. In his last note to us, Hans had said he would show us a sign when we got to this place.
Hans to come with us, I think. Yeah, ask him to come out with us.
Englander, Bobby Moore.
Yeah.
so well. He's been arrested, and of course, didn't have to say anything unless he wished to do so. Or you say, maybe give an evidence. But he's, we'll take him away now. We'll make sure he's all right. But he's done a very good job.
Bye,
guys.
Bye,
guys.
We'll watch him go off.
I think you could, yeah.
And so Hans spent the rest of his time safely looked after in a prisoner of war camp. And so, having successfully completed our mission, all that remained for us to do was to tidy up and go home. But the locals had been so impressed by our bravery that they had other ideas. We were asked to do a series of initiative tests to see whether we were good enough to join the Home Guard. As we'd worked so hard during the week, it was only fitting that we finished off with a party and some silly games. And seeing as we didn't have a street to have a street party, we had it up in a field instead.
Oh!